What's up everyone? Gaming with Bridget here, welcome back to another channel. Today I am doing something new. We are doing level 1, year 1 of Harry Potter Lego. I recommend if you haven't read the books or watched the movies, you don't do this because there are a few spoilers. We're not going to be collecting any of the house crests or anything. We're just going through the level today of these first few, and then we finish all the levels, including these five to seven, that's it. Once I've completed all those, once we've completed all those, whatever, we will be going through on free play. So right now, yeah, as you can see, I'm just heading over to Gringotts, collecting the spider, and the flower there. You need to use Hagrid to be able to get the ice cream. Just wait for it to explode. And then just head through. I made a mistake here. I realised I needed Hagrid as soon as I got up there. So you need Hagrid to cool that. And once he does, just head right inside. Now if you just want to complete the level, do nothing else like I do. All you need to do is head right up to the house, the elf in the front, not the house. If you hear a bird over the background, I have got a budgie and she won't shut up on a good day. So once this little thing completes, I couldn't skip anything, so sorry about that. But I figured it'll make it more understandable. You'll understand what's going on and all that. Okay, so here we are. Why am I talking? And we're about to move on. As soon as this finishes. That's the son of a smiley face. You need to use grip hook, I believe it is. Yes, grip hook to open the key thing there. There are some things where you need a certain spell that you don't unlock yet, which is a good reason why you don't go until, where you don't try to get anything into a free play. It makes it just a little bit easier because then you have all the spells and everything you need. I'm also trying not to get the true wizard status. Yeah, I don't want to get it. Just a quick note, you do get golden bricks for completing levels and classes, so take that into consideration of why I would have more gold bricks than I should when I do free play. I was gonna say something else, I completely forgot. Yeah, I completely forgot. When I figure out, I'll probably be at the end of the video. Oh yeah, in this one video, I will be doing all the years. Not all the years, the first year. All the levels in the first year. Level 1, level 2, 2, 6. To 6. You know what I mean. I didn't delete any of the clips, as I said earlier. Sorry, I'm trying to remember what I was going to say. Well, let's go, party. Yay! There is the Philosopher's Stone, or the Sorcerer's Stone, depending where you are. Now we're about to get our wand from... Let's go see Gringotts again. Ollivanders. That's it, Ollivanders. As soon as we do that... Oh, God. After we get the wand thingy... What? Yeah, wand. Yeah, sorry, about here, I got a little sidetracked, so excuse me, I am so sorry about this. Yeah, I just realised that I still have this recording, so I was like, oh shoot! And we're doing the wand thingy. On the original book, all he does is swipe the wand away as soon as he touches it. You know. I'm recording. And now we have our wand. It's about the end of the... whatever this is. Level. So yeah, I got Hedwig and a hat now. This is the end. And this is the next level. As you can see, once again, I skipped the button skip. I just didn't record the intro to the level. But if you've read the books, watched the movie, or even played the game before, you should know what it is. I got a little confused on the character. It wouldn't let me press the scatters for a second until I realized I was pressing the wrong button. What you got to do here is just press on those little things. There's one at the very far end, as you can see there. And once you get over there, I don't have stub magnet on, by the way. I haven't got any of those, and yet it's still saying that it looks like I've got it on. Like the last level, I'm not collecting anything, not yet. I found it really hard on this level because I know where pretty much everything is, and those fish, I know we just put them straight in the water. If you just wanted to complete the story mission and then go through a free play later on, I recommend don't putting the fish in the water. And that little spinning wheel thingy there, I don't know what it is, where it's shining by the looks of it, that needs a spell later on, so you can't even do that until you go through a free play again. Okay, yeah, here goes over the water, which isn't even on. Without money. And I'm building a trident, one of those, and giving it to the mermaid there. She's good at golf. She should be a golf person, I don't know. So, the troll, I don't know why she lets a troll in, but she doesn't let Harry or Ron in, when clearly that is a guy. Oh well. Yeah, we have this thingy, a little lamp for the wizard in there. He will go out with you, you blast him, and he will transform whatever character you have into a girl. You do have a time limit with this, so I recommend as soon as you are allowed to run and move around, you go. Because as soon as I got through the store, I transformed back. As you're about to see. Right there. Another little cutscene that I couldn't skip because this is the main story. I wouldn't have skipped it anyway. And here, out comes the troll. Run, Hermione. And because I thought it was going to go well with the story and the movie and whatever, Ron should have been the one to defeat the troll because he was the one that knocked him out. So that's what I did. First of all, I accidentally lost that. I meant to hit the troll, but I found out I remembered I couldn't. Started running because I remembered he's supposed to run after me, but he didn't, so I ran back. And yeah, he will run after you. All you need to do is get past the toilet, so just wait. And he'll run back as soon as you get past the toilet. Gotta wait a little after that. You can collect the studs there, or even blast the toilet and get the gold, the studs on the top. I'm not going to, because I'm lazy. And now you can levitate something to hit him on the head. I'm gonna remember, Harry did do something, so I might as well use him for one little thing. So, try to dodge the attacks or use the Wingardium Leviosa to hit him. And then I used Ron again and hit him with his own club, just like Ron made him do. Made it do, whatever. Then he gets knocked out, and it is another, whatchamacallit. I don't know why it flushed there. Yeah, as I said, if you haven't watched the movie or read the books, do not watch these. Because there is a lot of spoilers. Like, the entire thing is spoilers, so I recommend not watching them. Why is it flashing? I swear that didn't happen. And this is the end of the level. did it for 3rd year. Note, there is a trophy where you have to complete this level at this level, not other Quidditch levels, but this level under 5 minutes. I only just managed to get it with like 30 seconds remaining. So I recommend that if you just want to get nothing else, you try to get that trophy as well. I already have all the trophies, so I didn't really worry about that. But I didn't really complete them level under 5 minutes anyway, it was more like 5 minutes and a few seconds. So yeah, I finally managed to add one of the clips into the beginning, and this is it. All of a sudden, oh no! This one, all you get to use is Ron and Tomoe, but if you have free play, if you're doing this in free play, you get to use any character you want. As you see, I'm ignoring a lot of things here. There's other Wingardium Leviosa places. I'm just going straight through them, not trying to get anything. Hermione is a horror on a broom, by the way. It's like it's a rodeo bull thing. I don't know what they're called. Okay. This is where you are going to need Ron as well, or any person with a pet if you are on free play. But if you're not, then you're going to need Ron. He's going to need Scabbers. I kept on getting confused with the buttons in this level, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I did. I kept on pressing triangle instead of circle at one stage to get out of Scabbers. You can see there's the Golden Stitch, Bludgers, and whatever else. Now over there is the Ravenclaw House Quest. We are not going to worry about that, so if you just want to complete the main story, don't worry about it. Just completely ignore it. And when I go through them on free play, I will get through the mission. I got a little stuck here because none of the blocks were clicking in as I hoped they would. It was annoying me. So I just gave up and started climbing, as you can see. Missed it at first, but got it the second time. Lost with some things because I was too lazy to jump. Until then. Now over here, you want to knock out both of those rune things, and out of that you will get one of those rune cupboard things, which you need Hermione for. She will unlock it. Or I will unlock it, or whatever. Potions to moon. And outside of it will come some books and an axe, trying to chop them up for some reason. And instead of chopping up the books, it'll chop up their way, that thing blocking your way. As you can see up there, there is a Slytherin, I'm guessing Prefect maybe. Gotta hit the golden thing and then hit the wizard again. And it will pull the lever, which will dump him into who knows where. Then you gotta build a little bridge to be able to get up. I actually managed to do this one, sort of. If you can see down there, there is a character token. We are also going to ignore that and just go right up ahead. And over here, the last bit of the level, another rune cupboard. Hat, star, moon, potion. I almost pressed the wrong one by accident. I'll release these, which you can use to click onto there, which will help you get up, so yeah, you do need them. And then build a little staircase so you can get up there to get to them. It does do that. Don't know why, you don't really need to do that, but it does it anyway. There is a dark magic thing there, as you can see. You might want to take note of that. If you were on free play, that is. Yeah, I got a little confused. I couldn't remember what to do until I just randomly started hitting things. I was like, oh, you gotta hit that. And then it will unblock that. You go up, and it's another cut thing. Punch Slytherin. Where did he punch him? Jeez. Alright, and now they're trying to get, I believe it's Marcus Flint. No, he was the captain. He was a 60s, I'm pretty sure. It's supposed to come out of your mouth, not your ear. And we're back with level 4. I accidentally missed out on some of the clips, but I got most of it. Some of it, a really tiny bit of it. So yeah, now we have the invisibility cloak for Harry, no one else has an invisibility cloak that we know of.
Wow.
Yeah, see those books there? They will attack you, so you need the invisibility cloak to get past them. And just press triangle and you'll destroy the books completely. Once you do that, head over near the ghost. I didn't realize there was a book over there. Got killed by it. Yeah. So that was my mistake. Don't make that mistake. I don't know why I shot something. I thought I liked to get the book, but I didn't. You are going to need a strength. No, that's an explosion potion, I believe. Yes, you need an explosion potion. Don't mind that I hit one of those flowers. It said one out of six, I think, or one out of nine, one of those. Don't hit them. Shush! If you just want to do the main story. Yes, I've got a lab there. After I got this flower, I got a little stuck. I couldn't remember where the ingredients were. So, sorry if I'm just running around trying to remember.
Yeah, shut up. Lousy bird. I am.
Mice don't hurt, you know. Yeah, all I remembered is a book. I knew there was something up here, but I couldn't remember what. So I went up here. I thought the potions had something to do. The books had something to do with like a gold brick or something, but turns out they don't, so don't worry about those. I thought the dragonfly maybe would have given me something, so I followed it. All it does is hit itself and give us studs. So yeah, I was like, where the hell am I supposed to get the spider? Where the hell am I supposed to get this stupid whatever it's called? So yeah, I just went around trying to attack everything, trying to remember where everything was. I had a complete mind blank, by the way. I thought maybe there was something. Yeah, I attacked Mrs. Norris again. I thought there was something in here, but I just get studs. A few studs. I felt like there's something up here, which there is something up here, but I didn't realize it until later on, just a few more minutes, seconds, whatever. Yeah, if you want an easier way to get up than the Wingardium Leviosa, do that on these little plants and they'll get you a little way down and up, up and down. It was around here that I remembered there was one of the ingredients up on that shelf on that other balcony compartment area after I got these studs out. Yeah, right here. I remember there was something up here that I couldn't remember what, which is where I went to the books. Like, they don't have anything to do with it. Maybe if I destroy these, the spider was having to show itself. It didn't, and then I saw the spider thing up there. It's like, nope, that's just going to give me studs. Completely left, and I was like, I looked at the spider, I was like, oh, I know what I'm going to do. Whoops. Sorry. Don't know what that's about. Okay, and yeah, that's where we get the ice cream. Don't know what an ice cream is doing in there though. Should have better. Whether or not it's covered in ice. So yeah, once again I attacked Mrs. Norris. Then I remember there was something up here. I knew there was something on this side. So I tried to climb up here. Failed horribly. Then got it. Then I decided I'll attack random things. As soon as I attacked that, I heard a noise. Just like, oh my gosh, there is something to do with here. So I targeted it, attacked it. I had to move out of the way at one point because it would fall. And as you can see there, it is a dark magic, by the looks of it, spider web. That is something that you will need in free play, so don't worry about that until then. This is one of those explosion potions, so you just move away. Come down here and you'll be in the restricted section. Once you are here, I would recommend keeping out of your sight. You don't necessarily need the invisibility cloak to do that, but I only remember that a little while after this. So you, first of all, you want to attack those potions, blast them, whatever, and they will allow you to get this. I had to take off the invisibility cloak to be able to get this. Rona's just there in the background, like, what do I do? It never lets me place these things, so I just decided I'd try to get it. Eventually got it. See, my prop, I don't know if that's happening to everyone else, let me know if it is. So yeah, after that, I managed to get in and grab the key. If you saw up a little bit more, there was a Gringotts vault thingy in there. I can't remember, but I'm pretty sure that's where Student Peril or maybe even a character token is. I can't remember. And another one just off there. You want any scabbers once again to get up here. And he will knock over some books and a weird thorn looking thing. I don't know what that is. It's a part of the door. Once again, yeah, I made the mistake of pressing triangle instead of circle. Ron's actually doing something now. He's being useful. Then I decided to use him for the rest of the thing. Whenever he couldn't, at first I couldn't remember what to do here, and then I remembered, oh yeah, there's supposed to be bats or something coming out. So yeah, you go over there with Lumos. The bats will go upside down. What you need to do then is you need to hit them, and then they will reveal the mirror of whatever it's called.
Hmm. Huh? Ooh.
And then this is another little clip scene. Clip scene. I don't know what it's called. Poor Harry. And then there's Dumbledore just in the background, like, hello. Time for bed. And this is the end of the level. You know, it's funny because apparently Dumbledore's supposed to see himself with socks in this, but. And with level 5, I skipped a bit of the clip by accident. I didn't realize I wasn't recording until just a few seconds after, like just here, whatever. With this one, it does get a little confusing. Mainly because I got confused a bunch on what I needed to do. So yeah, you're not really supposed to see him. What we're doing here in the movie and the book, this was based in a detention. But with this one, all it was Draco scared away a unicorn. So now they're all trying to find it. Over here is a pretty good place to be able to get one of the trophies. It's Good Dog, I believe. You have to defeat 25, I think it was, levels, bad guys. You just stand around one of those hornet wasp nests and wait for more. I managed to do it over time. I've already got all the trophies, as I said earlier, so I didn't worry about that. At this point, I didn't realize it ain't fang. I don't know how the hell he can climb ladders, but whatever. You can see there's a dark magic thing there. They are a part of a gold brick. No, not a gold brick. A character token or something. House crest, one of those two. Couldn't remember what at the time though. So yeah, you get past this little level. I believe this is where I started getting confused. No, it wasn't here. It was just a little bit after here though. After this one. Yes, don't, defeat those, get those yellow flowers. I made the mistake of doing that. Yeah, Forsworn gets himself trapped. Need Fang. There's another one of those dark magic thingies. Fang will, I love Fang, so Fang. Yeah, down here. This is one of the shorter little level areas. Defeat that. There was another dark magic thing. I couldn't remember what to do here until I remembered. Got rid of that devil's snare, and now we're further in the Forbidden Forest. You can see up there that there are things. I can't remember. I don't know what they're called. Buildable bricks, whatever. I didn't see them, so I thought maybe they were down here or something. This is where I started getting confused because I didn't know where I was going or what to do. I went down here, realized I needed Fang, used Fang. He started digging. I'm not sure if Scabbers can do. Probably take him a few years ago. I've never actually tried it. No, I can't. Pretty sure. So yeah, after this, you will need Lumos again, which Hagrid doesn't have, so don't bother using him. And then you do need Hagrid, because this will reveal one of those strength character things. Once you do that, shush! That will go up. You know, you're very ear-splitting, you know. Give me a headache. Was at this moment, yeah, don't put those fish in the water if you just want to do the main mission and nothing else, because they, I believe, are a part of a thing. Yeah, it was that moment I realized that there was things on the spider web. I got those down. Once again, some of the blocks wouldn't click in, so I was just like, screw it, I'll just do it however I want. Yeah. Defeated another planet thing. Got rid of the nest because that was something from this morning, sort of. There is a dark orb globe there. If I remember correctly, that is where you get a character token. Can't remember which one though. Got some bricks, realized I didn't really have to go up there. I don't want the tourism status yet. I want to get that later on during free play, but I thought I'd also get some bricks up so I can unlock some characters when I needed them. So you gotta defeat those three spider webs, deal whatever this is, pass up a tree somehow. You can use Wingardium Leviosa, and it'll start spamming some new leaves. Gotta get climb on those leaves. I jumped, don't ask why. Yeah, be careful of that. I remember when I first went through this game, I kept on getting trapped in that because I forgot it was there. And now I've got another little clip that will end the video, not the video, the level. We've got one more level, I believe. This is. And there's Voldemort. And what's his face? I forgot his name. And now we are on to the very last level where I managed to get some of the clip in. I'm pretty sure it was from the start. Yeah, as I said, if you haven't read the book or watched the movies, this does have a lot of spoilers in it, so do not watch this unless you... unless you don't want to watch the movies and all that, you just want to go through the books, or if you have, you know, for Ron, he's actually kind of good at playing trumpet. Kind of. But it didn't really help. So yeah, once you get here, you want to hit the wizard with the rubber duck. He will throw the rubber duck. You want to hit it again. And use Wingardium Leviosa, and randomly levitate it around the dog, and eventually they'll take it. They'll go off to the side and see the broken top. You want to go over to the heart and fix it, and we'll start playing music. Gonna go off the trap door. The trap door's going to magically open, and you're going to go inside of it. And you're going to fall down to the this room. I got rid of these because I didn't want to trip over them. Yeah, if you want more gold, you can easily defeat those little red root thingies and you get through them. You are going to need Lumos and Lumos Solemn to be able to get through all this, because it's almost impossible without. After this, you realize there are floating keys. You want to target that, and they will start to fly off. If you want to do this little bit that I'm about to mention, do it now, whatever, before that. You kind of need to, though. Place the, use Wingardium, Wingardium Leviosa on the statue. It'll drop a broom. I recommend using Harry Potter since he can actually fly. And start randomly going around and hitting the keys. They will go in these places. And then you can just get off of this last one by the ass and just hang on. And then, turn the key and you head through to the next little area. Yeah, this one I keep on getting confused on which characters to hit and all that. I recommend looking out for which ones move. They're the ones you need to hit, whether they die or not. Yeah, I kept on forgetting that. Then you want to go up to this horse right after that and get on it. I don't know why, but I had to be wrong doing this because he was the original one on the horse. I got up and he goes through. There is a dark magic wizard chest piece looking out there, I think. Piece, whatever. And yeah, I fell off trying to get behind him. And once again, hit the person that's moving. I collected a bit of gold because I realized I was a bit short. He will move, get attacked. No, he just ran away scared. Use this character, keep it around. I did whatever. Now the queen will come out, attack that thing. I think it's a queen. That'll attack the king, I'm guessing. No, that'll increase by the looks of it. I don't know what that is. Then you have to build a character. I'm pretty sure that's cheating, but they're doing it. It takes two little building things to do that. I don't know why, but it does. This is the moment where I realized I needed to stop collecting gold or else I was gonna end up with the thing if I wasn't careful. It's not gonna take this long, this short to get all of them. I recommend having one of those stud doubler thingies, but yeah. And door opens and we go through. Ron tripping on the way, so he can't come. Just Hermione and Harry now. And as you see, Krill. Hello. Krill Voldemort comes out, and now it's a boss fight. If you don't go to trial, this will be the first boss fight. But if you do go to trial, then this is your second boss fight of the first 4 years. You gotta keep on dodging these fire attacks. I recommend keeping Wingardium Leviosa on because you do need it for, I'm pretty sure it's about to happen now. Yep. You use Wingardium Leviosa on the green skull, jump over the fire, hit him with Harry Potter, or just go near him with Harry Potter, and it'll burn him. You will use Wingardium Leviosa to pull you away, and that will happen. Now you gotta do it all over again. I believe you only have to do it once more after this. I just attacked these while I was waiting, collect a bit of studs. Didn't know why. It does take a little long for the skull to come out with every attack. But I did it. I guess I had to collect the studs behind there. Well, attack him, he uses Wingardium Leviosa, or maybe even Crucio, I'll be fine. The things get bigger and a little more difficult to cross. Now it takes a little longer for the attacks, for the green Wingardium Leviosa skull thingy to show up. But just keep on dodging those attacks. And make sure Hermione doesn't get hit either, because I remember hitting her at least 5 times with the fireballs. Yeah, it was my fault. One of those. And then there we go. One of the skull fireballs came out as I hit him, but didn't matter, dodged it. And here we go. End credit scene. End clip for level 6, and then we have another little clip that I decided to add. And that will be it for year 1. He takes a Professor Stone. That's it. Can't take the stone because he's only a ghost. And yeah, this is a little clip. Another little clip. Harry Potter wakes up from the thing.
Huh?
Because the falafel stone, she tucks in her bead, because everyone knows that the Dumbledore's bead is the safest place for anything. And, it's Bertie Bott's every flavor bean, by the looks of it. Yum. One that blows a bubble out of his neck, that will too. And that will be the end for this year.